Hey guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 3 of season 2 of Written Deductions. Let's go ahead and get started in 3, 2, 1, go. Skip the opening. Yours is off too. Damn. This girl was was one step ahead of y'all. You're lying. Yeah, but you know that's not what he wants, right? Seriously? for 2 minutes. Unless she's bluffing again. She is. But the thing is, what's the meaning behind it? We on season two, and we still barely know anything about it. Probably so. Cause she probably about to kill herself. Yes. Your own family member?
It is.
Of course, not her. That means somebody else in the police force is also working for the House of M. Took her body and replaced it with somebody else. Right. Yeah. I figured he would say kill her permanently. He's okay. I like him, but at the same time, I don't. You kill your own sister. Your own sister to teach it, like, not only a lesson for her, but everybody else who's gonna go after Ron. Be like, hey, you mess up. This is what's gonna happen to you. Milo. Milo. Excuse me. It sucks to the fact also that all three hackers died, because especially the one who was like over here in the last two episodes begging and pleading for his life, using a poisonous pill to just off himself. Like, that is a little messed up because I really thought he was going to be the only one to at least live and tell the tale. I mean, I had a little ounce of hope that Winter wasn't going to be dead, that she was going to be at the police station. Possibly being like, hey, if I tell you everything, would y'all put me under protection against my family and such? But no. That's why I feel like either one of two things. Oh, excuse me. Somebody in the House of M is clearly working with the police and is one step ahead of them. Or at the moment when she jumped, whoever. Oh, hold on. I gotta tell you, that cat is always asleep. Okay, whoever shot her was also a part of House of M, obviously. Now, if that same person went to go rescue her all the way down, even though, yes, she's in the between of life and death, and Milo was like, okay, go ahead and make the final kill and just take her out permanently. I don't know. I'm truly stumped, and it makes me kind of now think and worry, especially when we go into like the second half of this, and my knowledge of Sherlock Holmes, because I love the shit out of it. Is it gonna end with like both Milo and Ron possibly dying? Maybe. I mean, we don't know. We really don't know anything, and it's only episode three, about to be episode four officially tomorrow. But I really don't know. I am stumped. But these first three episodes, once again, were really good. I mean, I would have loved if we would have got it like into a four-parter, but no, I get it. It does make me wonder what tomorrow's episode is going to be. For episode four, but regardless, I am extremely excited. So hopefully we do get a lot of questions answered soon. I would like a backstory episode specifically on the House of M, so fingers crossed that that comes soon. Sooner rather than later. I don't want to wait like too long for it to come. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episode three of season two of Forbidden Deductions. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like, it really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Magical Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all tomorrow when I come home for episode four. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.